George Jetson was born in 2022, and we have forever been waiting for the Jetsons' age where we will all be zooming around in flying cars. In 2022, actually, flying cars are here, and they go by electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, eVTOLs. Now the question is, can they now be a part of the sustainability story? That is, when I move in an urban aircraft, will the energy consumed per mile flown be compatible with that when you go in a regular automobile? Now, surprisingly, the answer is yes, can be a part of the sustainability story as these urban aircraft consume energy comparable to, and in some very energy efficient designs, even less than that of an electric vehicle. The reason they're not here is the batteries. The batteries that are used to power these electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft are much too heavy today. And most importantly, they can't deliver the power required for takeoff and landing. The critical technological piece that's needed is to enable simultaneously what I call the AND problem, which is that you need to deliver high specific energy and high specific power, that is high energy and power per weight, which is the most important thing for aircrafts. The challenge in electrifying aircrafts by battery powered propulsion is that batteries are much too heavy compared to the jet fuel that is used. What that means is that we need to just work harder. There are three main technological leaps that will allow us to get there. First major technological leap that will allow us to design these batteries at a much faster rate is machine learning. Machine learning has enabled materials discovery and optimization at a rate previously unimagined. The second one is advanced characterization. That sounds a mouthful. The core idea here is that we can now go and watch what happens inside the battery. We can watch the atoms move, and we can really take movies of how the atoms are playing around inside a battery. This allows us to understand and hopefully control how they act and how they react so that we can use that understanding to design long-lasting batteries. The last piece, which I am extremely bullish about, is robotic experimentation. We have designed two robotic setups, Otto and Clio, that allows us to optimize battery electrolytes, one of the critical components in enabling long-lasting batteries autonomously and fully roboticized. With these three pillars, I believe, and we'll see battery-powered electric aviation finding its roots at the end of the decade.